Spurs hoping to be able to get the ball forward early on to exploit any slow start from the Geordies today. Guimaraes working it wide for Joe Linton. He's got Willock outside it. Joe Linton getting himself into a shooting position, almost a perfect start it is. It's taken Newcastle a minute. Jacob Murphy. And in this electric atmosphere, are Tottenham going to be running out of gas?
He should have been confronted. This is way too easy. It's terrible defending. Romero doesn't get there. Højbjerg just backs off and he allows Joe Linton to get that shot away, which should never have happened. And even though he does deflect it outside the post, Lloris, it's very alert follow-up from Murphy to finish, and finish in style.
61 seconds, all it's taken for Tottenham's remodeled defence to be breached. Oh, Joe Linton's made an excellent run for Romero's, let it go! Joe Linton, he's in again! 6 minutes of magpie magnificence and abject Tottenham defending.
Toro doesn't see the run to begin with and he's got his arm in the air in the hope of getting offside. And Romero again just remains neutral. I don't know what Romero's doing. He should be taking command there and go and deal with it, go and head it. But instead, and I must admit, the ball over the top is delicious. The control from Joe Linton is equally delicious. And knowing that Lloris was on his way out, that's really coolly taken. Shocking, shocking defending from the visitors.
Oh, it's three! It's an absolute stunner from Murphy. 8.5 minutes in, Newcastle United 3, Tottenham 0.
Well, we've seen desire, determination, fantastic drive and aggression, and to be honest, even if Lloris does dive, he's probably not getting to that because that's super accurate. It's brilliantly hit, and Newcastle are absolutely flying.
Stellini and Ryan Mason thought they had problems before the game started. It's a good ball to find Kulusevski. Burns sliding in to win it back, Guimaraes poking it forward, Willock. And he might have got Isaac in here, he has! And it's four! An extraordinary first quarter of the game. It simply goes from bad to worse for Tottenham Hotspur.
Well, the ball over the top for Joe Linton's goal was absolute class. But Joe Willock on this one, It's sumptuous. The Tottenham fans can't believe what they're watching. A little look outside of the right foot. Have some of that. That's absolutely glorious. And now it's a case of can you get the finish in? Well, in this kind of confident environment, yes, any of them seem to can. And Isak has got into a wonderful position.
And they're pushing forward again. Oh, they've done it again. It's Isak. An instant double strike. 2 in 2 minutes for the Swede. Tottenham fans already heading for the train home.
Every time that Newcastle decide to get on the front foot, it looks as if they're going to score, or certainly they're going to challenge. And again, this is just too easy. Passing through, nobody's committed. Nobody's showing any aggression and determination in the Tottenham defensive ranks. And even on that one, Lloris probably should have been doing better because of the angle.
Fraser Forster for Hugo Lloris, that is the change that is being made at half-time. No news yet whether that is a tactical change or whether that's because of an injury. The Forster, the one-time Newcastle United goalkeeper, is on. Perisic, Højbjerg, Harry Kane bringing it forward. So watching briefly Cher at the moment, who now tries to engage Kane. He's passed in, and it's in the corner. Spurs have one back at the start of the second half through Harry Kane.
Yeah, well, that was the key ball from Højbjerg to get him into the space. And now it's just a case of, can he get past Cher? He gets a little break because Cher does get a touch on it, but it seems to ricochet back into his path. But once Harry Kane then got that freedom and got away from the Swiss, there was probably only one end result.
It's more spirited start of the second half for Tottenham, but it's not a particularly high bar for them to get over. Now we're on finding Guimaraes. Longstaff has got Trippier outside him. Five in the penalty area, including Almiron. Little poke towards goal, and it's in for six. His first touch. Callum Wilson makes it half a dozen for Newcastle.
Well, where some of the goals we saw from Newcastle in the first half were clinical, this has some fortune about it. I mean, he ends up stabbing it with his toe, Almiron, and it's a big deflection. But you've got to give credit as well to the fact that Wilson was alive to it. And again, Tottenham far post are sleeping a bit. Porro doesn't react. And Wilson's got a simple task, really, of just placing it into the corner.
Olivier with a deft touch towards the far post, but Eric Dier's header couldn't find his fellow centre-half, Romero, and that will give Newcastle the opportunity to bring it forward. And all the centre-halves are forward. Only skipping Højbjerg back here as Newcastle maraud towards the Spurs penalty area, and Gordon can't quite make it seven.
Yeah, I think in making the break on the outside, Gordon always felt that it was likely to be threaded to him, and it was in the end. It just needed a dink. I think he just chose the wrong option.
...20 minutes that could be definitive in the race for a Champions League place. Newcastle mesmerising, Tottenham tawdry and terrible. A massive day for Newcastle. They beat Spurs 6-1.